Our houses need windows, so let's see how we can place them correctly in the 3D world. For this we will use events. Before we create a new map, let's rename all maps that we've made so far. Let's give them names so that we remember which tutorial they belong to. Create a new map and call it Windows. With the same outside tile set. Let's create some new buildings. Create an event somewhere on the ground and choose a window image. We don't need walking. For our windows, we will use events. And I will show you how to configure them properly so we can use them in the 3D world. When starting the game now, the window is just flat on the ground. So to change that, we have to use a function called shape. This function has different ways how the event will be configured. But for our case, we will need the wall shape. The code for all event configurations has to be written in this node tag window here. We start the MV3D tag like this. And every function has to be inside these tags. So let's add a shape wall function. Now the window is standing up without any rotations. But if we place it on the position where we want it to be, in our case the house, it's now on top of the house. So if we want to force the event to be on the same position but on the ground, we can make use of the Z function. The Z function will set the absolute Z position of the event. This picture illustrates better what we were working with. Since we are working in a three-dimensional space, we will always use the Z position, also the X and Y position, to translate objects. In our case, we want the window to be on the ground. So let's add a Z function with a value of 0. So it's set to the ground now. But when we start the game, it's not visible anymore. It's actually just inside the house now. To pull it out, we need to use another function called yOffset. This function will move the event on the y-axis of the three-dimensional space, like Z function will move every event on the z-axis, same with the x-axis. So let's add a yOffset function to make it perfectly aligned on the wall. We need a value of 0.51. Start the game. And the window should be visible now. If it's too close to the ground, we change the value of the Z position. So instead of using 0, we will use a value of 0.4. Let's copy paste the window. And the window is properly aligned now. If we want the window to show up on the other side of the wall, all we have to do is copy the event and place it over there, but this time change the Y value to a negative value. Since if we're working on this direction, we have to use a negative value of the Y axis. Copy paste the events to the other side, like this. And only add a minus sign to the Y offset. If we now want the windows to be on the right and left side of the building, all we have to do is to change the Y offset to a X offset. But since we are working this way, it has to be a positive value and not a negative value. And we have to add another function for rotation of the event. The rot function will rotate the event. 90 degrees should be fine. Let's copy and paste and start the game. If you don't want the windows to be so close together, all we have to do is to change the Y and X position as we need it. Let's add a Y offset function and use a value of 0.3. Copy this piece of code. And just paste it here in the second window event. But for the second window, we need a negative value on the Y axis. But now the windows are intersecting into each other. All we have to do is to switch their position. Like this. If you want them now to be on the other side, all we have to do is to copy and paste them and to change the X positive value to a negative one. First, let's close the old game and let's check. Now we have windows on all sides of the house. We just set up our windows for all directions and we can use them just by copy-pasting it on the other buildings. The left and right looking windows has to be copy-pasted separately. Since these two windows have a different Y position. In this video, we have learned how to use a couple of functions that you can use to translate or rotate your events inside MV3D. In the next video, we will learn how to set up doors.